Well, right now, bridges are made from steel, a material that corrodes over time. The goal is to switch that material out for carbon fiber, which has the potential to save money and make bridges safer.
It's nice to be working on something that's going to affect everyone. I mean, we all need to drive.
Lawrence Tech University senior Andrew Yarbrough is one of only about 10 students from the College of Engineering picked to work with carbon fiber. The work on this material dating back before his time at the university to the 1990s.
Whether you like it or not, concrete will crack.
Those cracks in the concrete allowing salt water to seep in, corroding the steel enforcement. That's where carbon fiber steps in.
Our job is to try to find the alternative for the steel bars and come up with good material that will last for 100 years.
This material has been put through the ringer to make sure it can withstand those Michigan weather elements.
So in the environmental chamber, we can simulate years of extreme winter, and it's the same strength, if not stronger, afterwards.
We have a fire loading chamber that we can test up to 3,000 degrees simulating fire.
So far, carbon fiber has been used in 13 different bridges in Michigan, like here on the 8 Mile Bridge over Plum Creek. There are plans to build two more carbon fiber bridges in the future, both on bridges a part of the I-94 modernization project. The chief bridge engineer for MDOT telling me carbon fiber does come with a price tag, but the payoff is long term.
The materials are more expensive up front. Obviously, when you're dealing with a new material that doesn't have the market saturation that a traditional material does, you're going to pay a premium for it, and we are. However, if you don't have to work on the bridge for 25 or 35 or even 50 years, the next generation is going to realize those savings.
The American Association of State Highway Transportation named this a part of their Sweet 16 top projects for 2020. I'm told the goal moving forward is to help other states study carbon fiber and ultimately help them implement this on their roadways as well. And if you're having any issues getting around Metro Detroit, just let me know. Send us an email at gettingaround@wxyz.com.